Hi everyone and welcome to DrChrono videos. In today's session, I'm specifically going to be training you on how to use DrChrono on your iPad. So just a brief run through on our two iPad applications and the different features you have access to. Now the two basic applications you need to have installed on your iPad are the check-in and the EHR. So the check-in application is going to be used by the front office, so you know, to check patients in and so forth. The EHR applications are going to be used by doctors to write, you know, patient notes, send out lab results, prescriptions, and so forth. In the EHR application, you're going to have a filter option on the top. When you click filters, it's going to allow you to filter the appointments you see in this list. So, I mean, if you were in a practice group, right, like, four doctors like in a practice group, if you want to see all of the doctor's appointments, you will click on all appointments, or if you specifically want to see only your appointments, you will click on my appointments. Then you have the date range. So from this list, you only see today's appointments. If you want to see like 3 day prior appointments, you can simply change the date range, right? You can also mark off specifically, you know, what appointments you want to see. So if you want to say, okay, I want to see all the appointments in primary office, and then exam room 1 and 3, right? So you can specify. Great. And you also have the status. Now, maybe end of the day, you want to make sure all your notes are signed and locked, right? So you can say, locked notes or unlocked notes. So if you want to get a list of all of your unlocked notes, so to make sure you're done for the day, signed off on all the notes, you click on unlocked notes and click on confirm. That pulls up all the appointments for the day or between the date range that do not have, I mean, that have notes that's not signed and locked yet. So you can simply click on the note, go off and, you know, sign off the note. Great. Again, you have the calendar options. If you want to go back to a past date, sign off on a past note or something, you can just click on the date and go back, right? Okay, so the three lines, you have a man with a plus symbol just like in the check-in application if you want to add a new patient. If you want to search for an existing patient, you will simply use the find patient option, right? Now, when you type in a patient's name from here, for example, choose the patient from the dropdown, it's going to take you directly to the patient tab. Now, when you go into a patient's note, right, you're going to see three different tabs: visit, patient, and then history. So when you go under patient, this is going to take you like to their chart. Right, so you can see their appointments, like past and future appointments. You can schedule an appointment for them. You can, you know, log a phone conversation, and you can see their demographic information. Now, when you're going to see a visit tab, so it lets you click on history, it lets you click on patient, but it will not let you click on visit. So visit meaning only if the patient has an appointment for today, you can go in and write a note. So visit is to write a note. Perfect. Again, you're going to have the version of the EHR application. Again, you need to make sure you're on the latest version. Messages. This one's going to show you a list of your incoming messages and faxes. All right. So I'm going to say incoming messages. I'm going to choose this message. So this is an incoming fax. Okay. Now I'm going to choose this fax. And whenever you open a fax or a message, you're going to have this button on the top that says save to patient record. So let's just say this is like a document you received and it's associated with a patient. You want to make sure this document is linked to their chart, right? Click on save to patient record. Search for the patient, okay? So I am going to attach this document to this patient. So you choose the patient and click on assign. Now this button, it's going to change from save to patient record to view patient record. And it's going to give you, so it tells you that this record is attached to this patient. And when you click this button that says view patient record, it takes you directly to the patient's chart. Right? Perfect. Now you have an option to assign tasks. So let's just say you wanna, you know, have your staff member take a printout of this document and hand it to the patient before they leave. Or maybe call the patient, right? When you click user, you're gonna see a list of your staff members and doctors. So you can choose the person you wanna assign this task to, choose the workflow. You can type in a note, maybe say, please print out this document and hand it to the patient, right? Click on assign. This is gonna be assigned to your staff member as a task that they need to work on. And you know, when they log into their computer, they log into their account, on the website, they're gonna see these three lines on the top. So they're gonna be notified if they have a task that they need to work on, right? You also have this option on the top if you wanna take a printout of this document or fax the document. Great. And all the lab results, just like in the website, you're gonna find it right here. And lab results is automatically gonna be attached to patients' charts. So you don't have to manually go in there and attach, you know, lab results to the patient's charts. Anything comes in via LabCorp and Quest will automatically be attached to the patient's chart. Great. You have data visualization here. Now, if you enter vitals for patients, and you wanna see all the vitals in like a graphical format, so for example, blood pressure, respiratory rate, height, weight, you click on it, you're gonna see all the vital information in a graphical format, right? Perfect. And then you have the meaningful use report. Okay, so this one gives you all the meaningful use requirements, all the meaningful use requirements, menu and core requirements. It shows you what you need to do to meet this requirement and whether you have met the requirement or not, right? Great, and you can also generate a report. Perfect. Template library. Now, a lot of our doctors create, forms, like template forms, and if they decide to share it, maybe they decide that, you know, another doctor can use this template, they decide to share it in the library, you're gonna find all of those templates right here. When you click specialty, you're gonna see this one automatically defaulted to your specialty, but if you wanna search for other specialties, simply click on it, and you can search by the specialties as well. You can preview all the templates created by our doctors. You can click on the template and you can see how they created it. If you decide you like this template, you want to use this template to write notes for your patients, click on use this template and click on confirm. Okay. Now this template is going to be copied over to your account where it becomes your own template. You can customize it. You can make changes to the template so it's yours. Okay. Perfect. And then you have the new ERX. Click on new ERX to send out a prescription for this patient. So you have this for medication name. We're gonna type in a medication. You're gonna get a dropdown with all the medications in our database. You simply choose the medication, enter the signals. I'm gonna say once daily, dispense and refills. Okay. Great. Now let's just say this is my medication. This is the medication that I want to send out. Now this is something that I frequently prescribe. So you want to make sure it's in like a favorite list for easy access instead of having you type it in every time. So you're going to have a star option right here. And when you press the star, it automatically adds this medication to your favorite list. You want to do another prescription, click the plus option, and that right here is your favorite list. So if you want to choose from your favorite list, click on favorite RX. So I'm going to use this medication. You see that? Everything automatically populated. So I did not do anything except for choose the medication from the favorite list, right? Perfect. Now, once the medication is in there, you will click on the magnifying glass so to search for the pharmacy, right? So you type in the name of the pharmacy. And what I would always suggest is type in the name of the pharmacy here, and where it says current location, type in the phone number or zip code for best results. Now on the iPad is really cool where it shows you the map, the exact location on the map, right? So it gives you this eye option. You click on the eye option. You can select this pharmacy. You can also add it to your favorites and set it as the patient's default. So if the patient, you know, is nearer to this pharmacy, you can simply set it as their default so it doesn't require you to choose the pharmacy every time. You say select this pharmacy, then you say preview ERX. Now the system is automatically going to check for drug interactions, and if there is any, it's going to give you a notification right on top. Perfect. And then you simply click on send ERX to send this prescription electronically. Now, just in case you want to take a printout of the prescription or fax the prescription from the iPad, press and hold this button for about 2 seconds and you should get an option to print or fax the prescription. Great. Now, let's just say you have an emergency coming, you can't send this medication out yet, or if you want to, you know, check with the doctor before sending the medication. Click this X option and say saved draft. So once you've completed your other work, you can come back, click the three lines, and click on ERX draft. So the medication that you were about to send out is saved in your draft box. So you can preview medication again and then send it out. Great. All the refill requests from the pharmacy, you will see it under Refill ERX, okay? And you're going to have three options to either accept the request, deny the request, or make changes and send it out, okay? Perfect. Mayo Clinic Patient Education. Now, these ones are Mayo education documents. So if you decide you want to, educate your patient on their ongoing condition, you can search by their condition from here and you're going to see all the Mayo related documents, right? For example, see all the Mayo related documents and you can simply share it with your patient. Click send to patient. It goes to your patient's on patient account, or when they come into the office and you hand them the iPad, they're going to get a notification while they're doing their check-in that you have shared information with them and they need to read it. Okay? Perfect. You have the new task option. Now, this is something that's not associated with an incoming fax or an incoming message. This is you're creating a brand new task. So if you want to tell your staff, please call patient or please block my calendar for a meeting, you can choose the staff member, right? Put in the name of the task, type in your message from here and click on assign. Great. Settings. If you want to turn on and turn off the sample data, and also if you want to know what your PIN code is. So you click PIN code, it's going to tell you what your PIN code is. You need any help, you can email our support team. You want to lock the application for some time, simply click on lock, and when you come back, it lets you sign in with your PIN code. Log out, you want to completely log out from the application. And then you have an activity monitor. Now this one monitors your, internet connection, your download errors, and so forth. So if you're having like a bad internet connection or something, this is going to pop up on your screen. This button is going to change to red, and it's going to say your connection to DrChrono is bad. So when that button is red, you need to make sure you don't save any information, right? Because with bad internet connection, sometimes the information that you enter, maybe your clinical notes, you're just about to sign off on your note, the information might not save. So just make sure your internet connection is perfectly fine. Great. I'm going to go back to my home page. I'm going to choose this patient. All right, so the same patient we did the check-in for. Great. Now, if you're going to be using Square to process payments from your patients, you need to have a Square app, okay, the Square app installed on your iPad. All right. Click on payment, you will enter the payment. So, for example, $400. You will click the Square button. So this is gonna have you enter the payment. Click on proceed with payment, and it's gonna directly open the Square application that's installed on your iPad. So from there, you enter the payment in Square and you can simply process the payment just like that. Great. Now from here, I'm gonna say patient chart, okay? So I'm going to just mark this appointment. I'm going to say it's in session. So when my staff are looking at the iPad in front, they know that the appointment is in session, right? So I'm going to say patient chart. So the first screen it takes you to is visit, right? Meaning you can write a note for the patient right here. Now, just before I go over these tabs, I want to show you this. So check-in information. This information is everything that the patient entered during the onboard. So if you want to, you know, before seeing the patient, quickly look at what they entered during the onboard, you can just click on check-in information. So this one is your additional information form. Whatever, you know, the patient types in into the yellow notepad for medication, allergy, and problem conditions, you're going to see all those comments right here. And then you're going to have the reasons for a visit and also questions and comments. Now you might notice the add to note switch on the top. So if you want to have this show up as a part of your note, let me show you. So I'm going to turn this switch on and I'm going to say view complete note. Let me show you what it shows up like. You see that? I have an extra section on my note that says patient provided reason for a visit and patient provided information. Right? So if you want to bring that patient information on your note, you will leave that switch on. If not, you will simply turn it off. Great. History of present illness. Now, you're going to see three sections under a visit: H&P, SOAP, and then custom. So the H&P and SOAP are preset templates, right? Default standard templates we give for every doctors. Custom. These are the templates that you create from scratch. Now, under the preset sections, you see where it says history of present illness, medical family, social history. These headings, it cannot be changed or deleted, okay? But the content, so whenever you click, for example, medical family, social history, you see with the content that shows up on the right, this one can completely be customized when you're creating your templates, okay? Perfect. Now, a couple of other fields that you can use while creating your templates. Again, these forms can completely be customized the way you want it, right? So yes or no fields, just like I explained, so very straightforward questions, right? Now, you can also make these yes or no buttons generate, like a sentence. Now, when you're looking at it, it says a follow-up. But when you say yes, and when you click view complete note, so it's going to say history of present illness, patient needs to come in for a follow-up. So just by clicking on yes, it generated this entire sentence, right? So it's basically the way you design your template, okay? Perfect. Switch options. So if a lot of doctors might want to, you know, generate a paragraph, like a default paragraph that shows up on most of their notes. So all you need to do, turn that switch on, and when I click view complete note right now, I have this entire generated paragraph just by turning that switch on, right? Perfect. You can use fraction boxes like this, so to separate between something generic, like height and weight, blood pressure. So if you want to say, let's just say your patient smokes, you want to know how many packs they smoke per day and for how long they've been smoking. So you can create two different boxes to enter this, right? Multiple selection boxes where you can click, click, click and have it added to your note. Single selection boxes where you can choose just one from the drop-down. Things for like level of pain or marital status, something like that. Comment boxes, wherever you see a pencil, when you click on it, it's going to bring up your keyboard and you can free text. Or you can use the dictation, click on the microphone option, have a headset attached, and you can just speak through and it transcripts everything, right? Now, sometimes when doctors, you know, start typing in their notes, all you can see is two lines of the paragraph that you enter, right? That's actually sometimes inconvenient. So if you want to see the information that you entered, you click on this pencil option. It gives you a bigger notepad so you can see what you're typing. And it does a character count for you as well. Okay. Click save. That goes into your note. And then the last option is a free draw. You can upload any image of your choice right here. Maybe it's a body diagram, a picture of a heart, a year, or something like that, where you want to, you know, simply mark off the level of pain or something like that. Have this picture attached to your note. Now, a lot of our doctors use this feature differently and they, you know, maybe upload a blank page. Okay, so when you click the free draw, you have just a blank page. They use the camera option. They take a picture. So if you want to take a picture of your patient's hand or leg, or maybe if they have a rash, you want to attach it to your note saying the patient has a rash. You can take a picture and click on embed in note. So the picture that you take is going to be attached to your clinical note. And when you say view complete note, that diagram is part of your note right now. Perfect. Going to go to the medications and allergy section. So if you want to add a new allergy, you will click this plus symbol. You will type in the name of the medication. Choose the medication from the drop-down. And click on save. You also have the status button. So if you want to make a medication active or inactive, right? And say save. You want to delete a medication from the list, click the pencil option, choose the medication, and click the delete button, right? Perfect. You have a reload button, and then you have all these filter options where you want to filter by drug category, drug ingredients, and so forth. Now, sometimes all these, you know, symbols might be confusing. But when you slide your screen, you're going to see a tiny description, like, you know, add, plus means add, pencil means edit, something like that. So again, just an FYI. Allergies. You want to add a new allergy. You click on the plus symbol. It's going to give you three different options. So if you are going to enter a specific drug, if you're going to be choosing from a class of drugs, or if it's like a non-drug allergy, maybe like a food allergy, you'll click other allergy and you will free text. Perfect. And if there's any interactions between the drugs, you're going to see a notification here. Perfect. And then you have the billing information. Now, these ones are billing profiles. So basically a combination of CPT codes, ICD-9 codes, HCPCS, and custom codes. You can create a combination. You create these lists on your website, and when you choose it from the iPad, all the codes just auto-populate, right? ICD-9, you can search for the codes, right, from whatever we already have in the system, or you can create a pick list, like a fee schedule of all the codes that you frequently use, right? So when you click on pick list, you can choose from the codes that you use and then have that added to the appointment. You also have the CPT codes, HCPCS, and then custom codes, right? Perfect. Now you can move to any of these sections, H&P, soap, or custom. You can move to any of these sections. You can use the fields from here. You can go into your custom templates. You can customize, right? You can use your custom templates as well. And whenever you don't enter information, so all these blank fields will not show up anywhere on your note. It's just wherever you enter information is what's going to show up on your note. And just before you move to any of the other screens, maybe go out from the visit screen, right? Go to patient or go to history or click on the home button. Make sure you click on view complete note just so all your information saves. Great. Now, the other thing I wanted to show you is how to copy a patient's previous note, right? Now, a lot of our doctors have, they want the ability to be able to copy a patient's previous note. Maybe the symptoms from last visit is the same, something like that, or medical family social history. They want to be able to copy something like that. You click copy other note. You're going to see a list of the patient's visits. Choose the visit. You can copy either the entire note or you can copy sections from that note. Okay? Now make sure your note is completely blank before you copy notes. Okay, so if you decide to copy notes, first copy the note and then start making changes. Because some of the blank fields from the other note, from the previous note, might overwrite any of this. Right? So make sure your note is completely blank before you try to copy anything. Okay? Great. And then you say view complete note. So it brings your note to you in a PDF format with all the information that you entered. Right? Just like that. And it spaces out, you know, patients' medications and allergies, codes, vitals, everything in tabular formats. Perfect. Now, if you want to sign and lock this note, you will click on sign and close. So this one locks your note, right? So it says success, your note is locked. It removes all the edit options from the left. And when you look at your note, it says e-signed by, it's going to put the doctor's name right there, the date and the time that you signed the note. Okay. Now, if you do want to make changes, maybe you forgot to add something on the note, simply click on unlock and you can make changes to this note. So when you say unlock, it allows you to make changes to the note. You want to take a printout or fax out this note, click actions. It gives you an option where you can print or fax partial. Now, partial meaning you can do sections on the note. For example, you only want to take a printout of the patient's allergies, medications, or only the soap part of their note. You can take a printout, right? Perfect. Now, I'm going to move to the patient section, okay? From here, you're going to see patient information. So this is the patient's demographic information, like basic information you have on the iPad, right? You want to check for eligibility. You will click eligibility, okay? And this one allows you to check for both primary insurance and also secondary insurance. It's like a real-time eligibility. Create referral. So if you want to send out a referral from the iPad, choose the receptant, so I'm going to say this person. So you type in instructions to the doctor. You can attach diagnosis and procedure codes. All the medications and allergies from the patient's list is automatically going to be attached, and also patient basic information. And this is what the referral is going to look like. Right? So a very basic referral that you can send out from the iPad. Okay. Perfect. Under patient flags, you're going to see the number of flags assigned for this patient. You want to add a new flag, click on the plus option, and in this dropdown, you're going to see all the flag types that you create from the computer. Okay? So you want to say patient is afraid of needles, for example, say save, and that's their added flag. You want to delete a flag, click the edit option, the minus symbol, and then to delete, right? Perfect. appointments is going to give you a list of the patient's past and future appointments. Now, when you click View, it's going to take you to the Visit tab, just to that appointment. Okay? Perfect. Schedule appointment is going to pull up this appointment page. If you want to, you know, schedule the patient in for the next appointment or something like that, you can do it right from here. Log a phone call. If you want to put in like a phone consultation. Now, if a patient does not have an appointment for today, so obviously the visit tab is going to be unhighlighted, right? So you can't take notes or something. But if it's a phone consultation, click on log phone call. Type in the title. So I'm going to say watch. Right. I'm going to generate a few macro buttons and I'm going to say save. So we're just logging a phone conversation. So let's just say the patient called in, inquired about their appointment or something like that, right? Click history. Now from here, whatever phone calls that you log, right, is going to show up in the history section, right? Do you see that? Watch, the one that we just added. So it all goes into the patient's history section, right? Now, let me tell you the other things you're going to find under the history section. Whenever you sign and lock a note for the patient, you're going to see a copy of that note right here. If the patient signs a consent form from the iPad, you're going to see a copy of the signed consent form, right? You send out a referral for this patient, you're going to see a copy of the referral as well. And whatever documents that you upload from, you know, like on the computer, everything is going to auto-populate here, right? Perfect. Now, we also give you an option where you can take a clinical photo. So if you just want to take a picture, maybe of the patient's hand or leg, not specifically have it attached to your note, but you want it somewhere in the patient's chart, maybe like a document, right? Maybe to compare from their last visit and now. You can go to either the patient or the visit tab. Click on actions, you're going to have an option to take a clinical photo. Now, once you take a clinical photo, once you click clinical photo, it's going to open your iPad camera. You take a picture, you click on use photo. It's going to ask you to rename the picture. So you can rename that image, you can attach it. So whenever you take a picture, just like how the phone log went into the history section, you're going to see the picture you take in the history section as well. Okay. Now, let me choose this phone log, okay, for example. So let's just assume that this is the picture that we just took, right? You click actions, you say free draw. So if you want to say, you want to show your patient, okay, you were having pain right here, you were having pain right there. You can use the different pen options. You can mark, you can make changes, right? Just like that, right? Just with your finger. You can rename this document. So I'm going to say follow up one, right? I'm going to rename that document and I'm going to say save as new. Save as new meaning it's not going to make any changes to the original document. So you see, watch, it stays right there. Nothing's changed. But we have a new free draw that's follow up one. And this is the document that we made changes to. Okay. Also, anything that you want to, you know, take a printout, fax out any of the documents in the patient's history section, simply click actions. You can send fax or take a printout. Right? Great. And on any of these three screens, so you go to visit, you go to patient, you go to history, you're going to have this heart symbol to enter vitals. Right? And you also have vital history as well. Okay. Now, with that, I've completed the iPad session, right? I hope this training was helpful. And if you guys have any additional questions, please feel free to reach out to support@drchrono.com. Thank you again for watching Dr. Chrono videos.